And Ecclesiastes also makes us understand that if you are born of a woman, that you are not exempted from sorrow, you are not exempted from heartache, you are not exempted from troubles. But our consolation is that God is a God of all comfort. So whatever your situation is this morning, be rest assured that God will make a way for you. Praise the Lord.
Not knowing how we get through this test, holding on to faith you know best. Nothing can catch you by surprise. You've got this figured out and watching us now. When it looks as if we can't win, wrap us in your arms and step in. Everything we need you supply. You got this in control, and now we know that you made a way. When our backs were against the world and it looked as if it is over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way. Looking back on where we come from, because of you and nothing we've done, to deserve the love and mercies you've shown, your grace was strong enough to pick us up, and you made a way when our backs were.
You move mountains.
You cause war.
that mountain. You cause walls to fall with your power. Perform miracles. There is nothing that's impossible. And we're standing here only because you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made
a way.
Jesus.
You made a way.
The Lord made a way for you this morning.
You made a way.
One more time.
You made a way.
Don't know how,
but you did it.
Upon miracle, there is nothing that's impossible. And we're standing here only because you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way. You made a way, Jesus.
You made a way
when it seems so good.
You made a way.
Oh. Woo! Somebody praise Him right now. Praise Him right now. Praise Him right now.
Let's go ahead and do it better for Him. I don't know how, but He made a way. I don't know how, but He made a way. I don't know how, but He made a way. You don't need to know how, but He will make a way. Christian friends, listen to me. When you use your mind to calculate the things of God, you are shortchanging yourself. You don't need to know how, but He will make a way. Go ahead and put it together. Come on now. Hallelujah. I want us to keep standing. We are going to read two scriptures. Let's keep standing. Two scriptures. Matthew 14, and we're going to read 34 to 36. Matthew chapter 14, 34, 36. And when they were gone over, they came into the land of Gennesaret. And when the men of that place had knowledge of him, they sent out into all that country round about and brought unto him all, let somebody say all that were diseased. And he besought him that they might only touch the hem of his garment. And as many as touched were made perfectly whole. Were made perfectly whole. There's a similar scripture in the book of Mark, Mark chapter 6 and verse 56. And whithersoever he entered into the villages or cities or country, they laid the sick in the streets, and they besought him that he might touch, they might touch, if it were but the border of his garments, and as many as touched him were made whole. I'm bringing you a word this morning. I have titled The People Jesus Met, and it's part two. Last week you had part one. This is part two. Next week you will have part three. In the name of Jesus. Let's pray together. Our Father and our God, we're grateful for this awesome time in your presence. Thank you for the things you will do in this place today. Thank you because the Bible will be alive to us. We will live the Bible today. We will see you move in an incredible way as you did in the days of yore. Father, we are grateful that you have heard our cry. Our prayer is in Jesus' name. I want you to walk up to four people and have a handshake with them and tell them, you may not know why, you may not know how, but he will make a way. You may not know how, you may not know when, but he will make a way. He will make a way where there seems to be no way. You may not know how, you may not know when, but he will make a way. Hallelujah. Thank you. Please take your seats. Take your seats. The Lord bless you. I want to warmly welcome all of us to our month of divine touch. I've prayed for you. I've asked that no aspect of your life will escape his touch this month. Last week, we began our investigation of the people that Jesus met. We saw him do his first miracle in Cana of Galilee, where he turned water to wine. And that was what we went home with last week. I hope the wine of your life is getting sweeter. Today we are going to focus on a few of those he met and touched. By the way of reminder, we said last week that there were a few common things with all that Jesus met. And just as a reminder, let me check with you what those ones were. Do you remember the first one? Yes, what's the first one? What? Almost all of them he met, he found in the gutter. You see that they were sick, they were halted, they were blind, they had leprosy, or they just lost the only child. All of them, he met them in the pit. Number two, what did we say? He said or did something for all of them. Is that correct? He said, the second one actually is that there was not one of them He left the way he met them. Is that correct? There was not one who went home the way he met Jesus. Number three. He did or said something to all of them. And then number four. None of the people he met ever got worse than he met them. The only person who became worse than he met them was who? Satan. Satan was the only one because Jesus dispossessed him of the keys of hell and death, as recorded for us in the book of Revelation chapter 1, verses 8 to 9. He says, I am the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, said the Lord, which is and which was and which is to come, the Almighty. Because, where is that? Where is verse 9? Pastor Deo Luz P.A. Well done. But you can also look at Colossians chapter 2 and verse 15. And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. Glory. Number five thing that we said last week that looked like common to all that Jesus met was that he lifted them up. He lifted them from where he met them. Then number six, we said all of them had a change of their situation. And then finally, we said there was no need in their lives that confronted them that he did not meet. That's by the way of summary. If we go back to the scripture that we read, when we go back to the scripture we read in Matthew 14, and when they were gone over, they came into the land of Gennesaret. When they were gone over, they came to the land of Gennesaret, and when the men of that place had knowledge of him, they sent and brought to him all, let somebody say all that were diseased. Hallelujah. All that were diseased. Let me show you five quick things in this story. Five of them. In verse 34, you will see when. That signifies that in the sequence of events, it was the turn of Gennesaret. Can you see that? He says, and when they were gone over, and I've said to God in the place of prayer on your behalf today, that our own when is today. That it is our turn today. It was their turn in Gennesaret, but it is our turn today. It is our turn today. Help me tell somebody, it is my turn today. Then let's make it popular for everybody. It is our turn today. It was the turn of Gennesaret. Say that. It was the turn of Gennesaret. It is our turn today. The number two thing that I saw there was that the men of the city, they recognized him as a solution to the challenges they faced. That was number two. Because when the men of that place had knowledge of him, and I just would like to check with you how you feel sitting where you are now, do you feel that Jesus is by your side? Can you feel him by your side? Can you see him sitting next to you? Forget about the man that is sitting by you. Can you feel Jesus on your side? This man of Gennesaret, they recognized that Jesus was on their case. They recognized that Jesus was available. Jesus was there. It was not a guesswork. They knew that Jesus was there. And number three, when they had this recognition, they spread the gospel abroad. Hallelujah. They spread the gospel abroad. they said it to everybody who was around the country, and they brought unto him all that were diseased. I like that. I like that. And I'm trusting and I'm praying that God will make you a channel of blessing. A channel of blessing to somebody who is diseased. A channel of blessing to somebody who is confused. A channel of blessing to somebody who is incapacitated. A channel of blessing to somebody who is looking desperately for a solution. These men, when they recognized that Jesus was there, they also took steps. And they went around the entire country. They were telling people, do you know that the solution is already here? Do you know that the Messiah is here? Do you know that everything we have sought for, the answer is here? That was what they did. They went around the entire country. They spread the gospel around. Wouldn't that be the same reason, friends, that you must not come to church next week alone? Hello. The men of Gennesaret, when they had understanding that Jesus was there, they went around the entire country inviting people to come. And they said, look, come. Come, we have found the Savior. Come, we have experienced him. Come, he's able to turn things around for you. Come, he's able to heal your sicknesses. Come, the doctors have written you up, but there is somebody who can say go in the name of Jesus. Come, because there is somebody who can still the storms of your life and who can say peace be still. Ladies and gentlemen, men and brethren, I announce to you that that person, Jesus, the maker of the ends of the earth, the one who was, the one who is, the one who forever shall be, the one who made the seven stars and the Orion, the one who sits upon the circles of the earth, is in this meeting this morning. Don't come to church next time alone. And ever so, tell your friend, don't come to church next week alone. Be like the Gennesaret man. They spread the gospel around. They said it all to everybody who cared to listen, that the solution was there. Number four, that thing that I see there is that they besought him earnestly. They made a prayer request. They made a prayer request to Jesus. And what was their prayer request? Huh? Tell me now. That they may touch. That they may touch. That they may touch. That they may touch. That was the only request they made of him, that they may touch, that they may touch the helm of his garment. Can you fancy that this whole building was filled up with people? And why shouldn't it? If we do what the man of Gennesaret did, this place will be filled up in time. When we tell them there's a solution here, that Jesus' permanent residence is in this place. And each time we meet together, he's here. My dear friend, you may not be able to. It doesn't look like it, but Jesus is in this place. Where two or three are gathered together, he said, in his name, he's there in the midst of them. How beautiful and how sweet is it for brethren to dwell together in unity. They made a prayer request of him that they can but touch the helm of his garment. Did they get a result? What was the result? As many, let somebody say, as many, as many, as many, as many, as many, as many as touched, as many as touched. What happened to them? They were made what? Not whole. You didn't get the scripture. They were not made whole, they were made perfectly whole. They were made perfectly whole. Somebody just came into this meeting this morning. You will not just be made whole, you'll be made perfectly whole. I like what I read in Romans chapter 15 and verse 4. Romans 15 and verse 4. He said, for whatsoever, including the story of this Gennesaret, that were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we might, through patience and the comfort of the scripture, through patience and comfort of the scripture, might have what? You know, there is hope for you. If there is hope for a tree, there is hope for you. A tree that is hewn down, when it gets the scent of water, it will bud again. My dear friend, there is hope for you. If there is hope for a tree, there is hope for you. If there is hope for a tree, there is hope for you. If there is hope for a tree, there is hope for you. And I've trusted the Lord that what took place in Gennesaret will also happen here today. Oh, you didn't hear what I said. No one is allowed to live here today without a definite touch. I have stood in the place of prayer on your behalf. I got up at my usual time. I carried upon my head a big basin. The diameter was about the size of the planet Earth. I carried it on my head, filled with the blood of the Lamb of God. And I saw myself dripping of that blood as I walked into the presence of the Father. I walked to the place where God is, and I made request of Him today on your behalf. All I've asked Him is that, Lord, that you may touch the hem of your garment. Will you touch today? I'm going to see very shortly. But let me establish for you the full power of attorney that was granted me. When you purchase a piece of land and the interest of that land is to be transferred, lawyers do something they call a deed of assignment. They give you the power of attorney. Don't call it like Yoruba people. They will say power of attorney. The power of attorney. I came into this meeting this morning with the power of attorney. And my authority is in the book of John. John 14, 12 to 14. John 14, 12 to 14. Verily, verily, when the Bible says, verily, verily, you must know that something serious is about to happen. Something serious is about to happen. Something very serious is being called to your attention. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do shall he do also. And greater works than this shall he do. Why? Because I go unto my Father. And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If ye then ask anything in my name, what will happen? Oh, let somebody shout, I will do it. I will do it. I will do it. I will do it. That's my authority. That's the power of attorney that I have received. Let me establish seven grounds for this power of attorney he has given me. Seven grounds. The first ground for the power of attorney that has been conferred on me, which is potent, which is capable of dislodging any challenge in this meeting this morning, is because, number one, Satan is a defeated foe. Oh, nobody said amen. Amen. Satan is a defeated foe. Amen. Read from the book of John, John chapter 12, John 12, 31 to 32. Now is the judgment of this world. John 12, 31 to 32. Now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the prince of this world be cast out. And I, if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto myself. I will draw all men unto me. Are you coming close to Jesus? There is no one who has come close to Jesus who did not get a touch. You will get a touch in this meeting this morning in the name of Jesus. Church, I want you to listen. I'm not playing on words. I'm telling you what will happen here today before our very eyes. Number two, the work of the cross was completed. The work of the cross was completed. If you see Colossians chapter 2, from verse 14 to 15, it says, Colossians 2, 14 to 15, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, and he took it out of the way, nailed it to the cross, and having spoiled, he spoiled, let somebody say he spoiled, having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing them over in him. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the second ground of the attorney, the power of attorney that has been granted me. He says, greater work than this will they do. In the days of Jesus, he didn't have large screens like this. There was no internet. As I'm speaking now, there are several persons who are watching us around the world. That did not take place in the days of Jesus. So, in some sense, we're already doing what Jesus could not do. We're doing works greater than what he did. People couldn't listen to him simultaneously all over the world. This is happening right now before our eyes. And it's a confirmation that greater works than this shall we do. The number three position that I have, the prop, number three pillar on which I stand with this power of attorney, is that Jesus is interceding for us right now. Do you know he's interceding for us right now? Do you know he's praying about this meeting right now? Do you know he's talking to Baba about this, your healing, right now? Do you know he's already talking to Daddy about your situation right now? Hear what Romans chapter 8 and verse 34 says. Romans 8:34. Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again. Who is it? Who is even at the right hand of God, who also makes intercession for us. Do you believe that? Do you believe that scripture? Do you know it is true? Do you know the scriptures cannot be broken? You know the scriptures are here in him, they are amen. He says he's making intercession for us. That is the number three pillar on which my power of attorney rests today. Number four, all authority. Let somebody say, all authority. All authority. All authority. In heaven, on the earth, down beneath the earth, they have been given to me. To support that, you can read Matthew 28:18-20. Matthew 28:18-20. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power, let somebody say, all power is given unto me in heaven and on earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you, even to the end of the world. Glory to the Lamb of God. The number five position, just 1 second, is that the curtain of the temple has parted and we have access to the holies of all. Do you know we all do now? Let me tell you what happened in the Bible days. In the Bible days, they did not have access. The high priest went into the holies of all. The people sat in the outer court. They sat in the middle court. But the holies of all was forbidden. They couldn't go in there. only one person went in there once in a year, maybe once in a lifetime. But when Jesus said it is finished, that curtain went into two and it made a way for us. By a new and living way, we have access unto God. We have access to the place of the dwelling of the living God. That is why, on your behalf this morning, I carried on my head a basin so huge, bigger than this building, filled with the blood of the Lamb of God. I was reeking of the blood. I was dripping of the blood. And I said, Lord, I made only one request on behalf of these people, that when they come, they just touch your hem and they will be made whole. And that will happen momentarily. Just give me, let me establish the prop for this attorney, power of attorney that has been given. How many have I given you? Number 6. The new covenant is based on better promises. Hello. The new covenant on which, by which we have, he said, gather unto me all my sons and daughters who have established a covenant with me by sacrifice. Where are those ones who have a covenant with Jesus? Let me hear a loud shout of amen. Oh, only a few people have that covenant. If you do, say amen. Amen. But now, I'm reading Hebrews chapter 8 and verse 6. Hebrews 8 verse 6. But now, has he obtained a more excellent ministry? By how much also he is the mediator of a better covenant, which was established upon better promises. Oh, tell your friend, better days are here. Better days are here. Because the mediator of the better covenant is here. And the covenant is based on better promises. Finally, number 7 pillar on which my power of attorney rests is that he has gone to the Father. Oh, I thought somebody would be excited about that. He has gone to the Father. 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 Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than this shall he do, because I go to my Father. He's gone to the Father. Mary Magdalene wanted to touch him as he saw him. She saw him in resurrection. He said, no, not yet. Not so fast. Don't touch me yet. I have not gone to your Father and to my Father. And he did not allow her to touch him. But now, there's the vacancies, the doors are open. He has gone to the Father. Now you can touch him. That lady could not touch him that day. But today we can touch him. Oh, you didn't get this. That woman could not touch him at the time. But today you can touch him. You know why? He has gone to the Father. And he's seated at the right hand of the righteousness of God, making intercession for you. He's already interceded for your situation ahead of this meeting. And I know he will touch you. I know he will touch you. I know he will touch you. The men of Gennesaret, they came because they heard that Jesus was there. Jesus is here today. Jesus is here today. And when the men of that place had knowledge of him, they sent unto all the countries round about, and they besought him that all that were diseased. Ladies and gentlemen, all of you in this meeting, who has one challenge or the other, I invite you to come. 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 They are sitting down. They are sitting down. I invite you to come. I invite you to come. I have made one prayer request on your behalf. I have made a request on your behalf. That all you will need to do this hour is to touch the hem of his garment. All who are diseased in this meeting, come. All who are troubled with one challenge or the other, come. Come to the fountain of life. Come to him who is able to do all things. come unto him, and they entreated him, they besought him, that he might only touch the hem of his garment. Hallelujah. 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 My dear friend, Jesus is in this place. I don't care the challenge you brought to church today. I don't care the trouble you brought to church today. These men, they knew that Jesus was there, and they made only one prayer request. They said, Lord, that we may touch the hem of your garment. And as many as did were made perfectly whole. Lord, I give you praise. 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 Lord, we want to live the scriptures. We want to see you do those things that only you can do. We want to see you do only those things that you can do. Mali moru kalihasa mahoto rikalima. Will somebody give me some anointing oil in this place very quickly? Ralohi masokiru balihama rabela. Raholi sahotori maluhobo rabili basama. Raholi mosu barihali bakama rabili basoma. Rakilohu sorila himu kori halisama rabela. Raholi moroli hibosu barihali marabela. Lord, that we may touch the hem of your garment. That was their request. La roli himu sahotori malihama rabela. La rimo luba santo rukalimo rohili basama. Liko subori halima. And all who touched were made perfectly whole. Oh, my Father, I give you praise for this time. Mali boruholi basama rakili baro. Raholi mosu bari haliko ruholi basa. Rikoli mosunta rikali habarakili basama. Rikoli masami koruholi basama rabila. My dear friend, you are standing there, you are not praying. All you want is to have a touch. I want you to have a touch, the hem of his garment. All you need to do is to touch the hem of his garment. And they besought him that they might only touch. That was all they were asking for. They didn't have any other prayer request. All they asked of him was that they might touch the hem of his garment. La roli himo su bari halima ramela. Raholi mosu bari hali bakoma rahili basama. Rahosunta rakili marohili basoma. Raloki saribo luhobo rabili basama. Raholi mosu bari halimo kori hali basama rabili. Now, church, I want you to listen to me. I want you to listen to me. I went to the place where God is today. While I was there, I carried on my head a big basin, bigger than this building, filled with blood from Emmanuel's side. And all I asked him, Lord, I said to him, as many as we touch, cause that they will be made completely whole. Can somebody bring me anointing oil? What is this? Lauru polisa hotori balihama. Riholi mosu barihalimo korihali basama. Raholi mosu barihali baro bilahama. Raholi muraki lahosu barihalimo robili basama. Lahurokili masohutori malihama rabil. Rikoli masama rakili baro. Thank you, our Father. Choir, you have time to sing. We have just five more minutes. But what I want you to do, church, what I want you to do, please don't rush. Don't rush. The men of Gennesaret, they made only one request and said, oh, that they may touch the hem of your garment. We cannot see Jesus physically here, but believe me, church, Jesus is here. Because of time, can you listen to me, please? Because of time, is this the only saucer available? Where are the pastors? the pastors, I don't need to teach you to be here. Mali rahosontari kali maramil. Ralohi sahotori malihama. Rakoli mosu barihali baro lihima. Lihosu borohili maro bilahama. Thank you, our Father. Now, church, I want you to listen to me. We do invest time on your behalf. This anointing oil enjoyed 21 days prayer in my bedroom, in my prayer room. The anointing oil I'm using for you is not the one they picked off the shelf. It was in my prayer room for at least 21 days. It's not that it's anything, it's just oil. But it's loaded. It's loaded. And by the faith of the Son of God, I said this is the helm of his garment. So what I want you to do, just touch and walk away. So that others can do very quickly. Just come, touch, put it on your head and go away. Touch it by faith. Let the touch be by faith. Let the touch be by faith. Let the touch be by faith. La roli himosu bari halima. Raholi boru, just touch and go. Touch and go. Touch and go. Lari boluho murabir. Rako sorihali maro. Just touch and no, don't go back that way. Just go this way, please. Go back this way. Just touch and go. Touch and go. Touch and go. Touch and go. Rali sohutori malihama. Raholi moru kali hasantoru kalima. Raholi masamara kili baroma. Just touch and go. Touch and go. Rali hosu borohila maro. Rali hisamori lahiborobila. Irimolu borohili masamara bila. Iroli himosu barihalima. Raholi mosu barihali. Raholi moru kalihasa mahotori malihama. Rigolu mori kalihama rabila. Rigolu moroli himosu barihalima. Rigolu morokili masoma. Ralo sori kali morohili baroma. Raholi mosu barihalima. Just touch and go. Touch and go. Touch and go. Just touch and go. As you touch the hem of his garment, you are made whole in the name of Jesus. Just touch and go. 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 Just touch and go. Go with the faith of the Son of God. Touch and go. You are made perfectly whole. Just touch and go. Touch and go. Your name is Yah. Oh, Father, we thank you. Thank you for your touch. Likosu borohila. Just touch and go. Just touch and go. Just touch and go. Just touch and go. Quickly, quickly, quickly. We don't have time. I have only one more minute. Let's touch and go. Just touch and go. Touch and go. Just touch and go. Touch and go. The queue is long. Let's make it fast. Just touch and go. Just touch and go. Touch and go. I can feel the presence of God in this place. Just touch and go. Just touch and use it to clean up your hair. Use it to clean up your head. That challenge is gone forever. That challenge is gone forever. In the name of Jesus. Just touch and go. 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 As many as touch. We are made perfectly whole. Ralo sirakoli bara, ravoli mosu bari halima, ravoli mosun tarakali boro, rabali mosun tarakali borohila, ravoli mosu bari halima, ravoli mosu bari hali, rakoli barahili basama, rikoli borokili masoma rakili baroma, ravoli moru kali hasama, rimolu borokila sahoto birakila. Just touch and go, just touch and go, touch and go. Just 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 touch and go. As many as touch were made perfectly whole. Lahu sori of whatsoever sickness they have. Raholi mosu bari halima robe. Raholi mosu bari halima. Raholi moru kali hasama rabila. Raholi moru kali hasama home. Just touch and go. Just touch and go. Just touch and go. Just touch and go. Touch and go. As many as touch were made perfectly whole. Ravoli mosu bari halima. Ravoli mosu bari hali. Ravoli mosu bari hali baroma. Rakoli masamara hilami. Ravoli mosu bari halimo kori hali. Just touch and go. Rakilo husori. Rakilo huro belahama. Raholi bosu barihali. Raholi bosu barihali baro. Raholi masama rakili baro. Raholi bosu barihali moro bil. Lahosu borohila. Raholi marakilo husori. Raholi as many as done were made perfectly whole. As many as done were made perfectly whole. Rakoli masama rahili baroma. Rakali moru barihama su barihali. Raholi bosu barihali baroma. Raholi marakili masoma. Raholi bosu barihali. Rakali moru lahi bosu barihali. Raholi bosu barihali. Raholi marali bosu barihali. Raholi moru kalihasa. Lahoru boloke morabe. Raholi masantoru kalihama. Raholi bosu barihali. Raholi moru kalihasa mo. Iroli bosu barihali morobela. Raholi moru kalihasa mahoto rabe. Raholi marakili masoma. Raholi moru kali maro. Rikoli marakili masoma rahila moro kilahama. Raholi marakili masoma. Moru kalihasa mahoto. Thank you, our Father. Yes, Lord, we thank you. Alright, may I ask that we all rise, please? Let's stand. Ralo kesami koruholi baro. I cannot close this service without giving our friends an opportunity. If he has not touched your life to make a permanent imprint on your life, if he has not touched you in such a way that your life will never be the same again, then all we have done here is wasted. I want all eyes to close, please, so that we can give our friends who need a touch. In fact, some of them need a second touch as they yield their lives to Jesus today. Where are you? I want to give my life to Jesus. I want him to touch me in a definite way. Let me just see your hand. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. I didn't ask you to open your eyes. Where are those ones who are saying, Lord Jesus, I need more than anointing oil touch. I need your definite touch in my life. Ushers, help me to bring them quickly. Please, quickly, ushers, help me with them. Help me with them. All over this building, up on the gallery, wherever they are, let them come. Let them come. Let them come quickly. Let them come quickly. Our time is far spent. Where are you? You are waiting for a touch. You are waiting for a touch. Please come. Please come quickly. Come quickly. Come quickly. Come quickly. Come quickly. La ri la himosu bari halimo robela. Ragosun tarali himoku bari halima. Please bring them. Bring them quickly. Bring them quickly. Ralo sohutori malihama rabela. This will be the greatest touch. The greatest touch. This is the greatest touch. Greatest touch. Why don't you come? Others who are sitting there waiting and looking, why don't you come? You may never have another opportunity because you have no guarantee that you will live till tomorrow. No guarantee. Why don't you come? All over this building, please come. Those of you who are in front, can you say this short prayer after me? Please come and join them. Please join them. Please come. Please come and join them. And just say after me, Lord Jesus, thank you for this afternoon, this morning. I'm a sinner. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Please write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. As from today, I will live for you. I will live the rest of my life for you. Thank you for hearing me in Jesus' wonderful name. Father, I want to thank you for these your children who have come. Please receive them into your kingdom. Let them have the experience I had over 40 years ago. That night I couldn't sleep. I was rolling on my bed. Lord, grant the same to them this hour. Thank you for hearing. For in Jesus' wonderful name we have prayed. Amen. Please get up. Please get up and go with these brothers in suit.